this is my game show for bookkeepers. It is called Guess That Expense. I'm your host, Morgan Law. Check out my website, finepoints.biz. And today we're going to be diving into the world of bookkeepers to figure out exactly how do bookkeepers know exactly where to categorize things. So I have a handful of transactions on my computer screen, and I'm gonna go through some of them and let you know exactly as a bookkeeper how I would categorize these. So let's get into the game. All right, welcome contestants. I used this format because I thought it would be a little more visually interesting. Of course, all of this is usually done in QuickBooks. So I'm gonna go through your options. There are 5 different categories that you can put each of these transactions in. So the first one is income. This is money that the business is making. Next one we have fixed expenses and variable expenses. So in an actual QuickBooks account, usually I would have a lot of categories for expenses. Like I would have utilities, rent, maybe software, office supplies. But for the purpose of this example, I just kind of kept it simple. So fixed expenses are things that are regular. So I put a little tiny calendar icon right here. So anything that you're expecting, like rent every single month. Then variable expenses, I put a little surprised face. These are things that, you know, you're not expecting. They vary month to month. Next one is payroll, paying your people. All right, and then we have owner's draws. This is always an equity account in QuickBooks, and this is basically like the owner's paycheck depending on their business structure if they are taking distributions from their business. So with an LLC, you do that. A corporation, probably you take a salary and then also owner's draws. So this one is pretty common, and it just looks a little different, so I wanted to include this one too. All right, contestants, let's look at our first transaction. So I started with one that is not too difficult. I'm going to click into it. It'll make it a tiny bit bigger, but I probably won't click into all of them. But this is an electronic withdrawal from Gusto. And then it does have the amount in the description box. We might not look at all of them, like I said. All right, so take your guess. Where should this be categorized? All right, Gusto is our payroll company, so we will categorize that under payroll. Nice job. And just a note about transactions within Gusto, usually these are matched because in Gusto, I have all the information in there and I sync it with QuickBooks, and then all of the info is already there. So instead of actually categorizing, it is called matching. It looks basically the same in QuickBooks. All right, and our next transaction is a debit purchase from Hiscox. What if you don't know what Hiscox is? In that case, I would just Google it. All right, and after Googling Hiscox, I see that it is an insurance company, so I know this is an insurance expense for my client. So where do you think this transaction is supposed to go? All right, you guessed it. This is going to go in the fixed expense. And this I think is an annual expense too, so it's not variable. It happens once a year. All right, let's talk about the next 2 transactions. These are a little bit tricky. So they are 2 transfers. So a banking transfer for account 1234 and a different transfer for account 5555. So in this case, you're going to need to know which of your client's accounts are these. And so I'm going to use my knowledge of this client to let you know that account 1234 is their personal bank account. This is a bank transfer that they had from their business bank account into their personal account. So where would you categorize this first one? That is right, into owner's draw. So again, that's an equity account in QuickBooks. It doesn't show up on the profit and loss statement, but it shows up on the balance sheet. All right, let's look at the next one. This is from a different account. And so for this client, I can see I have access to both their checking and savings in QuickBooks, and I can see that this account 5555 is their savings account. So maybe every month they transfer a little bit. How much do they transfer? $1,000 into their savings account. Good for them. All right, so this one is actually not necessarily a categorization. I would call this a transfer. So I don't have a section for that. I'm just gonna put off to the side here. All right, we're gonna start going a little quicker here. Okay, so next we have a purchase on your Visa, and it says SEC state. So I know that's the Secretary of State, and I know from the amount, because it is $200, that is their annual fee for their business license. So I will put that under fixed expenses. All right, and this is a payment to Intuit. So this is also going to go in fixed expenses. I'm kind of like wondering, I feel like actually I didn't do that many variable expenses. All right, and Intuit, again, this is just kind of to show you guys that it's not always super clear who the vendor is, but you will get to know them the more you work with a client. So now I know all these vendors really well. All right, and this one again looks kind of weird, but it says Canva in there. So I know that is their monthly payment to Canva. Same with Loom. I know Loom is a thing that people have used for business to do recordings and make videos. So let's put that in fixed expenses also. And the good thing about the fixed expenses in particular, that will not be the case with the next one, is that you get to know the vendors pretty well, meaning you kind of know where they're spending their money every month. And I actually have a spreadsheet for each client, and then I put sometimes, especially if they have something like once a year, I will put like maybe that Hiscock, that insurance, so I don't have to look it up all the time. I'll just put it in that spreadsheet, and I'll have the spreadsheet open while I'm categorizing in QuickBooks. And so then if there's one like, oh, I can't remember what that vendor is, or if I don't have a rule for it in QuickBooks, I can just go look it up really quick, and that saves both me and my client time in having to ask them what that transaction was for. Okay, so let's continue on. This is a debit purchase from Will Myers. I have no idea who that vendor is. I've never heard of that before. Luckily, there's a website on there, so I will go ahead and Google that website. All right, so after a simple Google search, I found this. He builds Squarespace plugins. So I would probably put that in my technology or software category within the variable expenses. So from that website, I feel pretty confident categorizing this. You could do a double check with your client, be like, oh, I categorize this new vendor in this area and make sure they are on board with it. All right, then they have Google G Suite. That is a expense that they have every single month. And then these other ones, these last three are deposits. So again, you kind of start to learn the vendors that your client uses for deposits. You figure out where they get their money from. So we have Melio, which is a payment like processing system, Stripe, and PayPal. So all of those, for the purposes of this, I'm going to stick in income. Sometimes your client might want different types of income categorized different ways. Like if they have, you know, if they're selling things and then they're also doing some services, there can be more than one bucket for income as well. All right. So this is a super basic visual illustration of what a bookkeeper is doing, what a bookkeeper does. So you can see the income. This is always at the top of the profit and loss statement. And then under that are all these different expenses. So fixed, variable, payroll, and actually owner's draw is not on the profit and loss statement. And some payroll things, payroll's a little bit more going on, but some of the payroll stuff are expenses in the profit and loss. A few things are on the balance sheet. So thank you for joining me today in Guess That Expense, everyone's favorite bookkeeper game show. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Check out my website. I have a free checklist on how to be a bookkeeper, how to start a bookkeeping business, and I have a class on how to get clients. Thank you very much for playing, and we will see you next time.